Welcome to Pluto, the icy world that sparked one of the biggest debates in astronomy. Is it a planet or not? Once considered the ninth planet of our solar system, Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet in 2006. In this video, we'll explore why Pluto lost its status as a planet and dive deep into the mysteries of this distant world at the edge of our solar system. Discovered on February 18, 1930, by the American astronomer Clyde Tombaugh, Pluto was initially celebrated as the ninth planet. However, as our understanding of the solar system evolved, it became clear that Pluto did not fit neatly into the traditional definition of a planet. With a diameter of about 2,377 kilometers, Pluto is significantly smaller than Earth's moon, making it one of the smallest known celestial bodies in our solar system. It orbits the Sun at an average distance of about 5.9 billion kilometers, completing one orbit every 248 Earth years. This distant orbit places Pluto in the frigid reaches of our solar system, where temperatures can plummet to around -225 degrees Celsius, or -373 degrees Fahrenheit. Pluto has five known moons: Charon, Styx, Hydra, Nix, and Kerberos. Charon, the largest and closest, is so substantial that Pluto and Charon are sometimes viewed as a double dwarf planet system. The smaller moons, discovered between 2005 and 2012, Pluto's surface is a complex tapestry of ice and rock, with stunning variations in color and texture. The surface is dominated by vast plains of nitrogen ice, towering mountains of water ice, and regions of dark, reddish material that may contain complex organic compounds. One of the most intriguing features is the heart-shaped region known as Sputnik Planitia, a massive basin filled with a frozen nitrogen ice sheet. This region hints at a dynamic geological history and ongoing surface processes. The New Horizons mission, launched by NASA in 2006, provided a wealth of information about Pluto during its flyby in July 2015. This groundbreaking spacecraft sent back detailed images and data, revealing Pluto's diverse geology, atmospheric layers, and dynamic weather systems. New Horizons showed us that Pluto is a geologically active world with a surprisingly young surface, challenging our previous notions about its inactivity. The data collected by New Horizons also offered valuable insights into Pluto's thin atmosphere, which is primarily composed of nitrogen, with traces of methane and carbon monoxide. The atmospheric pressure is much lower than that of Earth, but it still exhibits complex seasonal changes and interactions with the surface. So, why isn't Pluto considered a planet anymore? The discovery of other similar objects, such as Eris, Haumea, and 11 other objects in the Kuiper belt that share many characteristics with Pluto, contributed to this change in classification. If we were to continue considering Pluto a planet, we would also have to include all these similar objects, which could expand the number of planets in our solar system to around 20. As a result, International Astronomical Union in 2006 updated its definition of a planet to address inconsistencies and new discoveries. According to the new criteria, an object must orbit the Sun, be spherical due to its own gravity, and have cleared the neighborhood around its orbit to be classified as a planet. Pluto meets the first two criteria, but not the third, as it shares its orbit with other Kuiper Belt objects. This reclassification as a dwarf planet reflects a clearer framework for distinguishing between planets and similar bodies in our solar system. Pluto's reclassification as a dwarf planet may have sparked controversy, but it has also opened up new avenues of exploration and understanding. Studying Pluto not only provides a glimpse into the characteristics of distant icy bodies, but also helps us learn more about the diverse array of objects that populate our solar system. If you enjoyed this video, consider liking it and subscribing for more space exploration updates. Have questions or thoughts? Drop them in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you. Stay informed, stay curious. Thank you for watching.